Hi you guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm Devyani and in today's video, I'm going to share with you 5 interesting party game ideas. So before we begin, I kindly request you to subscribe to my YouTube channel and give this video a like and let's just get into it. So a few days ago, I decided to host a party at my house, an intimate party. And being the host, I had a lot of pressure to come up with the best party game ideas. And I went on the internet and I started scrolling. And all the games I found were so cliche, like, you know, balance the Oreo on your face or some card games. There were people who were recommending, you know, asking me to buy some game online and then play. And I did not want that. I wanted some games which were fresh, like obviously because of COVID, we had to sit at home and we could not go outside and, you know, run around the house. So I wanted some games which were, you know, stimulating intellectually, which had a bit of creativity. And you know, it was just super fun. And after scrolling for hours and hours and hours together, I came up with 5 different games. So I think I loved, like, it was, the party was such a hit and we had such an amazing time. So I thought I'll just share it with you guys and maybe you can be the best host ever at your next party. So if you have played these games before, do let me know in the comment box below. If not, you're gonna be the best host ever. So let's just get into it. So the first game is called The Liar's Den. So let me explain how it works. So have you ever seen shark tanks? So there is a person who has a product with them. They go in front of the sharks, they pitch their product, and if the sharks like it, if they're convinced, in return they decide to invest in the product. This is how the game works in general. So for example, you have a group of 10 people or 8 people. You divide the group in 2. So 4 people in one group and 4 people in another group. So as a host, you have to come up with 2 unique products. Why 2? Because there are 2 groups. So the number of groups, the number of products you have to come up with. So for example, I go to group A and I give a product like this. So this is an eyebrow pencil. How it works is when you turn it on, you can shave your eyebrows and shape your eyebrows, because during COVID, you probably could not go to the salon and this is really handy. So most girls might know what this is, but for guys, they don't know. So maybe group A has all girls and group B has all guys, like a unique product which nobody can guess. So as a host, you go to group A and tell them, this is the product, this is how it works. And out of the 4 people, one person will come up, will have the true story of what the product is. But the other 3 people have to come up with unique story ideas to try to convince group B that that product is not what as it seems. Like, here is an example.
This product is called Flawless. So when we are getting ready for a party, you need to look good. The girls need to look good. So we need to have a highlighter or something. Instead, why don't we have something that does cheek sculpting? So you vibrate this and massage your cheeks so that your cheeks look plump and nice. And then you get a highlighter natural. That is the use of this product.
Okay. Listen to all the stories. So the name of the product is Black X. It's used for blackhead removals. So this is how you use it. But anyway, how to use it, you could, to wash your face, they give a cream along with the product. You put the cream and then it's a product.
Can you try that?
So when you are at a party and then your boyfriend or nowhere tells you, you go back, it's very quick way to use this.
Many of you may know that me and Dave had braces growing up, but you don't know this, we used to go to the same dentist. And dentist recommended you should brush after every meal and you should floss after every meal, but they couldn't hold it. So they came up with a water toothpick. You must have seen it in ads and stuff, but it's a bulky machine usually. It's supposed to fill water in it, plug it, and flossing you can create like gaps between your teeth, so this avoids it and gets rid of the plaque while keeping it safe. But the problem they faced is that people wouldn't carry it with them around. So they came up with this portable water pick. It's supposed to fill water in it, and you switch it on, you will get a jet of water, you clean your teeth. It also has a whitening option available, the light, instead of having a whole tray and everything, you get it, so it really is flawless.
So as you saw, like, everybody came up with a different story of what the product might be, and the group B has to discuss within themselves and understand, like, oh, which pitch was real, like what this product could be. And believe me, nobody could guess that this was an eyebrow pencil, because every story was so convincing and so unique in its own way. So it was really fun, and like, none of the guys could guess like what this actually is. So this was a win for team A. And for team B, I came up with this product. If you guys can guess what this product is, like, comment below. Like, I just want to know what you think this is. And at the end of the video, I'll reveal what it is, but not right now. So basically, the team B had to come up with 4 different unique stories of what this product can be. And they came up with the things like, you know, in a school to punch papers. Someone said it's used in drilling. Someone, like, really creative. Someone said it's used in a bar to, like, you know, shape ice or something like that. But actually, this is a, I'll tell at the end. So do comment below your guesses of what this thing might be. So the second game is called
this game, 4 people are chosen for each round. 3 out of the 4 people are taken to another room where they cannot hear what is going on in the party room. The person that remains, which is the 4th person, is given something to act out. Before they start their act, one of the adults who is out of the room is brought back in. So basically, out of 4 people, one is in the room, he has been given a sentence, and the 3rd person is called back inside. They are told to watch the 1st person's act very carefully. So the player one begins their act, and no one is allowed to tell the 2nd person what the actual scene is. When the 1st demonstration is completed, the 2nd person takes their place and performs the same thing for the 3rd person without actually knowing what they are doing. And the 3rd person performs it for the 4th person, and the 4th person has to guess what the sentence was. So it tends to get really, really funny. We were given the Marathi phrase, Khakela Karsa Gavala Varsa, which translates to this. And we had a blast of a time. Here are some prompts you can use for your next party while playing telephone charades.
So the 3rd game is called Word. So I found this game on the game show, the general fun game show by Kani Surka on YouTube. And I found this game was really interesting. So how this game works is...
In this round, I am going to go into the audience and get one word. You will then have to guess what the word is. If you do not get the word that is written on the clipboard, you have to justify why your word is closest to that word. All right?
Yeah.
Does everyone know how this game works?
Yeah?
All right. Can I get a word, please? Word is...
Oh.
All right, everyone... Rahul, do it. What is the word?
Fine, fine.
Okay, what is the word, Rahul? Please, can I have the answer now?
Fuck. Chart.
Oh, man. All right, guys. The answer was not what you guys said. No one got the right word because the right word was nachos. You guys have to explain why your word is closest to nachos. In the most creative, poetic way possible. You know, however you want to. Remember, whichever answer I find the best gets the points. Not like you'll just get points for talking. All right, Rahul Dua, we'll go with you. Why is nachos closest to chart? What
you can, you can, you can, like, yeah. for additional flavor, you can chart the nacho also. You know, more better.
Okay.
Is chat
lick also?
Yeah,
oh,
yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah,
wow, that was a good, that's good.
Yeah.
Okay.
And you know, like if you take like as a triangular 6 nacho,
yeah.
You'll put them in circle.
Yeah.
You'll not only make a base for chart, the eating chart,
oh.
but you'll make a pie chart also. Like
actually, as a host, you have to pre-decide some words, then ask each member to say a word at random, then let them explain why their word is closest to your original word. And the one who comes up with the best word relation, like Rahul Dua did, wins. Such a fun game indeed. So the 4th game is called Song Associations. So this game is for all the music lovers out there, which is essentially everyone who doesn't love music. So in this game, the host has to divide the team, like the people from the party, into teams of 2. So group A has 2 members, B has 2 members, C has 2 members, la 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 la. Okay, so how the game works, everybody gets a sheet of paper.
And then you play this video online. There are a lot of song associations games on YouTube. So I've added some links in the description box below. So basically you have to guess the song by that word. So when the 1st word comes, you have to be really ready. Like the 1st word is, for example, crazy. You have 10 seconds. So I can write songs like, hey, I just met you. This is crazy. Here's my number. Oh, you got me feeling so crazy right now. So like crazy kiya re. So right now I just could think of 3 songs. So in the similar way, the contestants have to write as many songs as they can in 10 seconds, and the pressure is really high and it becomes really fun, and I love this game.
So the 5th game is called
In the game Great Minds Think Alike, there is a person who is the host. So basically the group is divided into mini groups of 2 or 3 people, and they are each been given a piece of paper. So the hosts ask questions like, It could be any sort of question. Like, which is the best Taylor Swift song? Who is the most talented person in the party? What do you notice first while on a date? Or anything like that. So let's take for example a question like, which is the best Taylor Swift song? So each of the member have to write what they think in their opinion is the best Taylor Swift song, but also try to understand what other people might be thinking. So for example here, group 1 wrote Love Story, group 2 wrote Teardrops on My Guitar, group 3 wrote You Belong to Me, and group 4 wrote Love Story. So as you can see, group 1 and group 4 have written the same songs, and that's why they get a point. And this game can go on forever and with so many questions. This is so much fun and so competitive, extremely fun. You must give it a try.
So these were the games, you guys. Of course, these are not drinking games. Like, of course, you can have like a beer on your side and chill and drink and just play these games. But if you want to know some nice drinking games as well, do mention that in the comment below and I will make that video for you as well. Now let me reveal what this is. So this is essentially used by dentists to make sure that dentures align well. So my neighbor is a dentist, so she gave this to me. So basically you just have to put like teeth or something like that here, even I don't know it very well. But basically you just have to align the teeth and make sure that when they're making dentures, the teeth close properly, something like that. So this was the product. Could you guess it right? Could you? I bet you could not. Like, if you're a dentist, otherwise, like for a general people, I don't think it's very easy to guess. And this was the video. I hope you enjoyed it. And definitely, if you have a party coming up, do invite me, because as a host, hosting these games, I had an amazing time and I'm sure playing it would be much more fun as well. So this was the video, you guys. Take care. Bye-bye.